ready to make some music?
My name is Betsy Hartman, and I'm a board-certified music therapist. I've been practicing for four-plus years.
Should we do improvisation, or we just make up our own song?
Alistair is a four-year-old little girl. She's been at the hospital in and out for most of her life, or half of her life. She is incredibly spunky and has moved here from Montana. So she's here with her mom while her dad and her sister are back home, and she's receiving her treatment. My family were musicians, and growing up they always encouraged me to be involved with music and play instruments, but it wasn't until I saw a harpist playing when I was a little girl, and I thought, that's an instrument that I want to play when I grow up. And as I started playing it, I realized that it had an effect on people, whether it helped people relax or soothe people.
Okay, here's your cat piano.
So I find that with cancer patients, we use music in two, you know, main ways. I might be using it to help with some of their rehabilitation goals. When you feel so sick and you have so much medicine that you're taking, you know, you're exhausted and you might not have the motivation to want to move, and it might hurt, it might be painful to move, and so music can be used as a support to increase that motivation, to make moving fun.
Oh my God!
Sometimes they don't need to move and they just need to relax, but they're going through a really hard time in life. They're missing school and they're missing their friends and they're missing their routine, and so that's emotionally exhausting, and maybe we'll use music then to help them be aware of that and express some of their feelings around that through songwriting.
Sitting in the chemo room, I made you go boom, 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 boom. I'm leaving you so soon, soon, soon.
This was a piece by a teen that was going through cancer treatment and used her raps as a way of expressing what was going on for her.
Finding helps me cope when I'm being poked with a needle from chemo.
Music therapy practice in the United States was first kind of recognized in the 50s. That was when the National Association of Music Therapy was established. But music therapy work has been going on here for a long time.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around.
Music is processed really throughout the brain.
Oh, I like that one.
And not only throughout the cortex, but also deep in the brain. I mean, our cerebellum is involved in rhythmic processing. And some really interesting studies are being done about how music can change the brain. And they were seeing that dopamine was released when listening to music that was pleasant, that was found to be pleasant and enjoyable.
You want to start with that? Twinkle, twinkle. The nature of being in the hospital is following rules and getting things done to you to help you feel better.
What you are.
For kids, that's hard. For adults, that's hard. And as a music therapist, we can really come alongside them and meet them where they're at. If they need choices, we can give them choices and let them choose an instrument. And it's a simple choice, but it's a choice.
Up,
then we go down.
But I wonder what you are.
Yay! That was beautiful. You did it.
Yay!
High five.